Good afternoon, everyone. I am Xavier Jurado, project engineer at R&D, a company specialized in air quality, and a PhD student in his last year at Ecube Laboratory in Strasbourg. And I will present you the work I did on associating deep learning with computational fluid dynamics to predict pollution concentration field in the urban area. So, first of all, I will introduce a bit the air pollution issue for the one that doesn't know much about it. So it's an ancient issue. Even in early human civilization, there were traces of blackened lungs due to air pollution. But it became even a greater issue with the Industrial Revolution, with the detrimental effect of it on the environment. And especially after 1952, with the Great Smog of London that killed about 4,000 people. So what are the data nowadays? Nowadays there are about 8 million people that die prematurely each year due to air pollution. In Europe it represents 500,000, mostly due to fine particles and secondarily to nitrogen dioxide, and then a bit of ozone, because of ozone. So this problem should become even a greater issue, because more and more people are living in cities around the world, and cities are the area most prone to air pollution. So it is estimated that 9 out of 10 people live in areas exceeding World Health Organization recommendation. So to tackle this issue, as I said, the World Health Organization implemented a threshold to respect. So there are annual threshold and hourly threshold. So annual threshold is to evaluate a long-term effect on the health, and the hourly threshold is to evaluate a short-term. And the European Union imposed regulation to its member state to check the exposure of its inhabitants. So since there is a regulation, there is a need to be able to assess the pollution. So to do that, what we do is that we have several models. So the air pollution issue can span from continents to a street. As you may guess, you don't use the same model for continents and for streets. So, I am specialized in urban areas. So for urban areas, there are two kinds of models. There is the Gaussian models. Gaussian models are good because they can cover wide areas and are fast to compute. However, they have a major drawback, is that they do not take into account buildings very well. And in urban areas, it is a big issue. So what we have also is CFD models. The CFD models is for computational fluid dynamics models. So they are more complex models. They are based on fluid mechanics equation. So fluid mechanics equation are the equations that allow to describe how a fluid behaves, and air is a fluid. So they are able to take into account a lot of complex phenomena. So how we can see on the image here on the top, we have a variation of the air speed. And for example, with the building, you can see what is called the street cannon effect with a zero circulation of the air. And that is not possible to take into account with a standard Gaussian model, for example. So with this kind of model, is it possible to do a lot of things? So for example, the company I work on, we evaluated the pollution in Paris of an highway on 2,000 housing. We also use this model to evaluate the pollution from a heat plant chimney in Strasbourg. And also on the images, what you can see on the bottom right, is the pollen dispersion of a square. So it is the trees, and the color are the level of pollen in the air. So what is the issue with this CFD model? As I said, they are complex. And since they are complex and need a lot of computing power. So it is not possible to use this model, for example, to predict in real time over wide areas. So to tackle this challenge, the idea was, is it possible to use deep learning models to reproduce safety results but faster? So the idea that we used here was to adapt a deep learning model used to treat spatial images. For example, conventional autoencoder neural network. So we tested several models, deep learning models. It will also be soon to be published paper normally. And we found that the multi-resonant was the best one. And so what we did with this model is that instead of giving a cell images, as it was done, because it was a model for medical images, we give the geometric data of the neighborhood. So here we can see it is the height of the building seen from top. Here is the distance from the pollutant source. We don't see it very well, but there is a distance. And the corresponding dispersion pollution determined by the computational field dynamic model. So we train our model on several configurations and several configurations and geometries. And so now what we need is a way to assess if our model did well or not on a real case. So to do that, we covered the south of the city of Schiltigheim, which is a city near Strasbourg. We covered an area of more than 1 km². So as you can see on the right, it has 27 roads. We only have the data for 4 roads, for the 4 main roads, and the other we made assumption for the sake of it. And we use the data of the 1st of April of 2021 at the peak traffic hour, which was in the morning. And so we use this data to make a CFD simulation and the deep learning simulation. So for the CFD simulation, what you see on the top, the first image is the concentration field. And the right image is the velocity field. So we modeled all the city in one go. It required a week of computation on 96 CPU. So as you may guess, it is not possible to do that in real time. So what about the deep learning? For the deep learning, my artificial intelligence can predict on squares of 100 by 100 meters. And it required around 3 minutes of computation. So the speed up was about 1000. However, there is one thing to note is that the CFD give results in 3D, while my deep learning model give only in 2D. However, to determine at pedestrian level the exposure of people, it does perform 1000 times faster. So this enable to do it in real time. And actually we are doing it in real time in the city of in the south of Schiltigheim. With real time data. So now to compare the results. So here we have the deep learning results. Here we have the CFD results. So in the air quality field, there are 3 metrics to determine if a model performs well. FAP2, and then normal mean squared error and functional bias. The definition is there of the term. So to determine if the model performs well, it needs to be above the threshold or around the threshold. So for the FAP2 and the functional bias, it performs really well, and for the normal mean squared error, it is around the proper value to be considered a good model. So with this example, we validated that our model can perform well and way faster than CFD while managing to reproduce it. So to conclude, the deep learning approach is more than a promising approach. It is already a tool that can be used in real life to predict on a large scale pollution exposure of pedestrian, as I showed it. And it is indeed actually being used in the south of city of for the city of Schiltigheim. So actually I am also currently developing tools for everyone to test the solution. So the tools will enable people to test rapidly my model. So you can draw buildings, giving a height of the building, drawing the road, giving the number of vehicles and their speed, and then you will have the sorry, the discussion of. Thank you for your attention.